Hi, thanks for tuning in. This video is intended as inspiration rather than instruction, so please don't ask too many detailed questions about my formulas, as this is part of how I earn my living and I'm not prepared to give away my exact formulas. In this video I'm showing saltwater deep etching of 316 stainless steel. I use a combination of chloride, sulfate and phosphate salts in an acid environment, and the power is supplied by a DC welder. Whilst there's been editing for most of the video, the actual etching portions are shown in their entirety and in real time to show how quickly this etching actually does take place. The resist that I've used is computerized cut sign vinyl. It makes for a really good insulating resist and is easy to produce on a simple sign cutter. Agitating the solution helps prevent the metallic deposits from building up and arcing out between the positive and negative electrodes. The welder really ramps up the reaction speed, so you need to be careful of heat build-up, particularly at your electrode connection points. The water also heats up, and this can, if it gets too hot, cause your resist to float off your substrate, which would be catastrophic for your etching. At this point you can see I nearly had a bit of an accident. I've really got to get down to making myself a more stable electrode holder. After 2 minutes of etching, I stopped the reaction to check on the rate of etching, make sure that everything is going to plan and not proceeding too quickly. It can be a little bit unpredictable, as the rate of etch is determined by the exposed surface area and is actually fairly hard to calculate for lines of text and picture graphics. In researching this process, I discovered a lot of useful information dating back to the turn of the 20th century. There's a fair bit of hardcore electrochemistry reading to do, a lot of theory about electrons and atomic nuclei, etc. But it's worthwhile reading it to get a really good understanding of how the process works. Of course, while you're etching, it's important to ignore such distractions as ringing phones that you can hear in the background. I just think, I'm etching, go away. Most of the information that I found was available online, although I had to delve into a lot of PDF photocopies of old chemistry manuals. After a third minute of etching, I'll see that the etching has reached the required depth, which is approximately 0.1 of a millimetre. This gives a nice deep etch that holds the paint well and gives a nice appearance. the bottom of the etch is also textured by this process as well, which is a really nice appearance for the final product. The paint fill process consists of a few coats of acrylic primer and then a few coats of enamel gloss black paint, turning the job during the application of the paint ensures an even coverage of the paint throughout the etching. After giving the paint a few hours to dry, I can then remove the resist and get a look at the final job. It's fairly painstaking removing the resist as they're all the small pieces that are caught up in the middle of the